athletics, man.
I talk a lot about the mental side of things and the major impacts that it can have on performance. I constantly stress the importance of having confidence and how it can make all the difference in the world. But there's another essential quality that I have not touched on yet, and it's a quality that can separate the good players from the truly great ones. That quality is competitiveness. Travis was not at all happy about me showing him up in the last video. He, Joshua, and I worked out together the next day, and he demanded that we compete again. He made it clear that he didn't just want to show that he wasn't far off. He wanted to win. And to be honest, he almost did. Whenever I play against my guys, I talk a lot of trash. I do this because it sparks that competitiveness in them. They stop thinking, of course he's gonna win, and start focusing on what they can do to shut me up. You have to want to win more than you care about looking good, more than you're afraid of making mistakes. When you're playing, winning has to be the only thing on your mind. When you enter that mindset, there's no overthinking and no fear. You end up playing at the highest level you can because you're so focused on the moment and on doing whatever you can to get the job done. I want to awaken that competitive spirit in all my guys and get them in the habit of always playing in that mindset. Last video, I spoke about how Josh came up big down the stretch of one of the games that I watched, and about how he dominated in his next game as well. But his parents tell me that he's too nice sometimes. He has a tendency to play too relaxed. But if he can learn to play with the same fire all the time, if he can say to himself each and every game that he's just gonna completely destroy the man who's guarding him, his game will go to an even higher level. I want him working out with Travis for that exact reason. Having them compete against each other allows them to both improve at a faster rate and get used to competing against someone who always pushes them to be their best. Igor has a lot of moves in his arsenal, and he executes a lot of our drills extremely well. But this month, I learned that he needs to learn how to execute against actual defense. He knows how to do the moves. Now he just needs to learn when and where. To learn that, all he needs to do is to keep competing and trying the things he's learned against defenders.
There you go. Good.
And speaking of competing, he says he wants to be a better defensive player, but he's just not competing on that end. So Igor, I'm gonna put you on blast here a little bit. You can't say you want to be a better defender and then have this effort defensively. You can't get better at it if you're not gonna try to be. So next time, let's see some fight. Let's see more of a, you're not gonna scorn me again type of attitude. Zach has an issue similar to Igor offensively, where he would learn all these moves but wouldn't be able to execute against actual defenders. But I'm proud to say that he's improving in this area. Yes, Igor wasn't playing the best defense here, but Zach knew how to take advantage of that. Zach also played with me in the men's division of the TG for Life tournament. It was great for him to play in one of the most competitive summer tournaments against grown men, and I'm sure it opened his eyes to a few things. Now, I just want to take a minute here to say congratulations to Zach. He recently left for TLAP, a prep school in Florida. This is a great opportunity for Zach, and words can't express how proud I am of him. So do your thing down there, Zach. Play with confidence and a killer mentality each and every time you step on that court. Bring out that competitiveness. Now I'd like to introduce you to another player who will be featured in this series. His name is Orion Skoblo. He attends school in Moscow, but will be training here with me for the rest of the summer. He'll be beginning his first high school year this fall, and he is hungry to make that varsity team. He has a long way to go, but as I said, he's hungry and eager to learn and improve. I can't wait to see how good he gets by the end of the summer.
Oh, that's a burpee. That's a burpee. Let's get three in a row. You're not tired. You're not tired. All right, that's one. Good.
Constantine joined me for a few athleticism training sessions since the last video. A lot of people ask me what the key to jumping higher is. Now, there are a lot of factors, and there isn't one specific thing that I could say is the key, but from my own research, observations, and personal experience, an essential ingredient is simply jumping more. Doing various types of jumps while implementing proper mechanics trains your body how to be more explosive and efficient. Constantine is making great strides in those areas. Travis and I have been training vertical jump for years now, so it's no wonder why his vertical was recently measured at 35 inches at the North Pole Hoops Showcase. Let's see if we can get that to 40, Trav.
Hey!
At the end of the last episode, I mentioned that AJ needed to get stronger and learn how to better handle physicality. So to do that, of course we did strength training. But I also had him work out with Travis, who's older and stronger than him. AJ's a competitive kid, and he didn't at all like getting smacked by Travis. So now I'm sure he'll make getting stronger an even bigger priority going forward. But I also taught him a few tricks to countering that physicality. It was also great to watch him kill the competition in his age group of the TG for Life tournament. I worked out with Josh a lot last month, and he was probably my most consistent client. And while we did a lot of work on his actual skills, I also made sure to express to him the importance of being aggressive. His team made it to his age group's championship game of the TG for Life tournament. And while I'm not going to take credit for what happened that game, I like to think that I at least helped a little.
Right here. 20.